And now it's time for Corner Table. It's our exclusive theater review segment. It features legendary critic John Simon and newcomer Justin Brown. Simon, as many of you know, he wrote for New York Magazine for more than 35 years. He's written for the New York Times, the Washington Post, and too many to count. Justin, he's an actor and director. He also reviews plays. Well, tonight, they take a look at a new play called Bernhardt, Hamlet.
Hello, hello, Corner Table friends.
Hello, hello, John.
Hi there.
How you doing?
Pretty well so far.
Love that. So today we're talking about Bernhardt, Hamlet. It is by Teresa Rebeck. It stars an intense list of people. This review is gonna be a little different. I unfortunately was not able to make this show. I will be seeing it on my own, but John was insistent on us getting to talk about it because he really enjoyed it. So John, talk to me about your initial thoughts on this.
Well, it is the best non-musical show around these days. Teresa Rebeck is an interesting writer. She has written more than 30 plays. And when she's good, she's very good. And when she's bad, she can be very bad.
Mm-hmm.
But at her best, she's considerable. And again, it's an intelligent play. She has clearly studied the life and activities of Sarah Bernhardt in great detail. She was the antipodes of one kind of subtle, underplayed acting, which was not the fashion at the time, mm-hmm. or very expressive, very exaggerated, very intensive,
right.
very romantic kind of acting. This Sarah was a wonderful woman. She did crazy things. She slept in a satin-lined coffin much of the time. She did all kinds of daring and different things. And she very much wanted to play Hamlet, which is what the play is essentially mm-hmm. about. And that was a very daring thing to do. After her, there were other people in other countries who were women playing male parts. But this was the first, I think, major, very major male part played by a major woman
right.
actress.
And I think ultimately, having read the play, what's exciting about this is getting to explore a very persistent actor seeking middle ground, seeking equality, seeking the ability to be seen as just as powerful, striking, and capable as her male counterparts, and somehow continuing to have pushback against that. And also kind of allowing men to support, some men, to support her decision too, I think is an important part. I think right now we're at a point in our history where it's really difficult for men to be seen as genuinely supportive or, even sometimes feminist.
Well, it's also a play about theater,
right.
about all aspects of theater. There is Janet McTeer, whom I've never liked before, but whom I do like in this. She is the bravura actress, but there's also a critic, Louis, who is quite intelligently written. There's also the lover who wrote plays for Sarah, Edmond Rostand. A history play, which this is two things. It's one part history and one part drama.
Right.
And the thing is how to combine the two things. And many people who try to do that fail. Whereas Rebeck did, did a very good synthesizing the two aspects. And you do feel that you're seeing something modern. And in a way, perhaps, the Sarah's acting may even have had something modern about it. So that you do get a sense of both history being satisfied, essentially, with exception, and drama and comedy, because she's a very funny playwright, too. And all these characters are well taken. The adulterous playwright having an affair with the diva, the leading actor and his problems, the problems of a woman wanting to play a male part. There are many problems, but unlike Apologia here, the problems all flow together seamlessly and support each other rather than militating against each other.
Well, thank you, John. Ultimately, if you want to check out this great piece of writing, of acting, it's also scenic design by Beowulf Borrett, so you know that it's going to look great. Check out Bernhardt Hamlet, American Airlines Theater, Roundabout Theater Company. They always seem to kind of impress me. So let's check it out.
Sounds pretty good. We'll be right back with a look at the horrendous weather heading our way for this weekend. Stay with us.